Hey, how you doing today? My name is Mark Daniels. Drew Long asked me to make a video on how I stay in shape, so I told him I would. Well, he didn't actually ask me to make a video. He asked me to make a post. So I prefer to speak to people. If you've talked to me on the Messenger or any of those apps, I prefer to use my voice rather than use messages or words in that respect because they get misunderstood. I can communicate better this way. So here we go. How do I stay in shape? Well, the first thing you have to remember is you are like a three-part being. Your mental, emotional, well, actually four parts. Mental and emotional, which you could say is the same thing. Spiritual or metaphysical energy, however you want to view that. And a physical being. So you have mental, emotional, spiritual, and physical. You have to address all of those aspects of yourself if you want to stay in shape. Now, a person can really look good on the outside, be in shape, ripped, muscular, but he may not project the beauty that he really has because he doesn't think of himself on the inside. He may have a bunch of trash or garbage on the inside of him. That's why a lot of these guys think, man, I'm ripped, I'm hot, I look great in the mirror. And these girls, they just don't seem to be attracted to me. How many times have you guys seen a beautiful girl out there with a guy, let's say, that is somewhat challenged in the looks department, and you think, how did he do that? Well, the first thing is you have to remember, women do not look at men the way men look at women. Okay? You look at the outer beauty much more than the women look at the outer beauty. The problem is you think women think like men and they don't. Not even close. Okay, well, I'm getting off track. But that's something you have to remember when you're thinking about getting in shape. If you think if you get that great muscular rib body that it's going to get you all the girls, you're sadly mistaken. There is much more to it than that. Excuse me, that will get your foot in the door. It will do that, but that is about it. After that, it's who you are, what you are on the inside. Now, how do I stay in shape? Well, when I was about 20, I'd gotten into some trouble, and I got into boxing, amateur and professional, so I stayed in shape in my 20s doing that. Okay, I mixed that between doing that and triathlons. All right, so I used to swim, bike, and run. I did that during that time. I boxed, I sparred. I recommend that you get somewhere, a gym or something where you can have some contact sports. Get punched in the face. It's good for you. Makes you feel like a man, all right? And that way, if you ever have to use your physical abilities and you get into a fight to protect yourself or your woman, you know what it's like to be hurt so you don't freak out or don't know what to do if you get hit and you see stars. It's no big deal. Stars are no big deal. And it also gives you a feeling of confidence that you know you can protect yourself and your woman. And she will pick up on that. This is part of the inside. Staying in shape is not just about what you look like on the outside. But if you're in shape on the inside, it manifests itself on the outside of your body, what you look like, how you feel inside. Will project or people will perceive you as that. Sometimes I hear people say they're ugly. There was a guy that posted maybe on this thread, Facebook thread, I'm on several of them, that he was ugly. Guys, help me. I looked at his photo. He's not ugly. But when that guy looks in the mirror, if he was serious, he thinks he's ugly. What do you think you are? That is so important. What do you think you are? I remember when I was younger, when I wasn't living a very good life, I would look in the mirror and I thought, man, I need to be a little bit bigger here. I got a little fat here. That had nothing to do with it. It was what I was seeing on the inside I didn't like. I thought I could change the outside and leave the inside alone. So if you want to get in shape, you have to remember, I'll post a couple photos of what I look like on my body and I'll also post a photo of my son and I just about a month ago sparring, or a month and a half. I still do that. And like I said, I'm 60 years old. I do it because I believe I can do it. Okay, I stay in shape because I believe I can stay in shape. I look good because I believe I look good. And thus I project that out there. It all has to do with how you feel about yourself, what you think about yourself. The body you see that I have now, I saw it here many times before it ever became a reality out here. It didn't just happen. And I could go through all the details of how it happened or the exercises I did, but that's not the point. You have to start where you're at. If you can't do one push-up, do a push-up on your knees. Instead of going on a diet which doesn't work, eat one less bite. These are the things that I do, okay? I can do more than one push-up. I hate push-ups, but the point I'm making is don't go to the gym, work out for an hour when you haven't been there for months or even years, and then you wake up the next day and you can't really move. Start where you are. What do? I work out every day when I'm not. I have a physical, I don't want to say job because I'm self-employed. I have several businesses, but one of them is I'm a painting contractor. I climb ladders, I paint. I love to do that. I run my butt off all day, not because I have a boss telling me to, but because I love to do that. Okay, now when I'm working like that, I'll only work out 3 to 4 days a week because any more than that takes a lot of energy out of me. Okay, but like right now, I'm a little slow, so I'm not working every day. So I'll work out maybe an hour, hour and a half a day, sometimes twice a day, sometimes only a half an hour a day. You have to listen to your body. What do I do? I do sit-ups. Well, they're not sit-ups. I'm not sure what they're called, but they're kind of like crunches. That's about all I do for my stomach. Okay, I bench. Now you might look at me and think that I bench maybe my body weight. I would be hard-pressed to bench my body weight. I work out with about 100 pounds. I might do 6 sets of 6 reps, okay, on the bench. And I'll do, flies. I do some of those. And I do sit-ups. They're not sit-ups. I'm not sure what they're called. But it's kind of a crunch, kind of a scrunch for my stomach. Okay, what do I eat? A typical day of me eating, I will fast from like 10 o'clock at night if I'm not working. Like right now, I'm at home. I'm in the office working all day. So I'll eat maybe at 9 or 10 right before I go to bed. Everybody says that's wrong too, but you can do that. Depends what you eat during the day. Okay, and I won't eat again until noon the next day. Now, if I'm working, when I get up in the morning, I will eat breakfast. All right, I do that. Now, I'll back up a little bit. The other part of my routine, like I told you how many days a week I work out and what I do basically, I just work out with the weights. I don't kill myself. I used to run a lot. I love to run, but it takes a little bit too much out of my legs, and I don't like the way I feel when I'm working on my my job. I don't like the term job. It reminds me of just over broke. Okay, but on my business, let's put it that way. Like I said, it's very physical work. I could stay in shape just doing that, but I like to tweak my body. I like my muscles to show in certain places. So, but now I told you, I only bench about 100 pounds. I would be hard pressed to bench my body weight, which is about 155 right now. At one time, I was 172 when I did triathlons. I was much bigger up here because I was swimming and I was bicycling. So I did a lot of, my legs were a lot bigger and my buttocks were a lot bigger, a lot stronger, a lot more muscle mass there. But I have a good V shape. That's what girls are attracted to. So, but I don't do it so girls like me. That's the wrong reason. I do it so I can like what I see when I look in the mirror. Always in my life, except for a short period of maybe a year or two, I could always take my clothes off in front of any woman and feel good about myself. If you have to have the lights off to take the clothes off because you don't want her to see your body, you need to do something with it. Not for her, but for yourself. It's all about how you feel about yourself. It has very little to do with getting a woman. It's about how you feel about yourself. It's just really important to remember that. Because as I said earlier, people think if they just get in shape that the girls are going to chase them down. It doesn't work that way, I'm telling you. Okay, so take care of yourself spiritually or metaphysically or energetically, however you want to say it. When I get up in the morning, well, first I lay in bed for about 15 minutes or a half an hour. And I say affirmations. I see myself living and being and doing the things that I want to be and do and live. Okay, very important. Then I get up, I do another 45 minutes. Sometime, if I'm not working there again, if I'm not working, I may do an hour and 10 minutes of contemplation and visualization. I have photos on my wall of the places I want to go. I have several photos of men with ripped abs and muscular bodies that I model myself after. Okay, I use those things. I have my room would be maybe considered like somewhat of a mad scientist because I have expressions and words written all over my walls things I want to remember. It's repetition. Just like repetition in the gym builds your muscles, you get cut, you get in shape, you look great. Repetition of affirmations of what you want to become, who you want to be, as if you already are. You do this every day. Affirmations are, let me see, I have it written on my wall. Affirmations are reminders that what you seek is already here. I have other things like this. For women, get her to understand your perspective by way of her imagined feminine intuition. You lead covertly. These are things I need to remember when it comes to women. These are things that I use to strengthen my mind, to remind me of the things I need, the tools I need to use when dealing with whatever situations in my life. I have many of those things written all over my walls. So I'm single, I can do that. If I had a woman here, she'd be pissed because I got this crap all over. But I don't, okay? I'm single right now by choice. I've been married 4 times. I have 8 kids. I've been raising these 6 by myself for the last 9 years. This, my last ex-wife is out of the country. I haven't seen her for 9 or 10 years by her own choice, which suits me just fine. I'm very fortunate. But another thing too is hang around young people. Most people my age, and a lot of them even younger, are going to the senior citizens place playing bingo. Nothing wrong with that, just not my cup of tea. When you're hanging around with younger people, you realize that they have aches and pains. My boys work for me. So when we get off work, okay, they are complaining, they're stiff, they're sore. Hey, guess what? I am too. If I were not around them, I would start thinking that it was because I was getting old. No, it's because you're living life. You're living life. I'll make a quick thing about what I eat daily. I think I was starting that and forgot. When I get up in the morning, like if I'm going to work today, I won't eat till noon. But what I will eat is I may eat a can of tuna, which I like in oil. I drain the oil off, but I leave enough on there to taste good. Some crackers, I'll eat vegetables, and I have a banana or something. I used to eat a lot of protein bars, but really they're just glorified candy bars. Anything out of a box is probably not that good for you. Okay, I'll eat 4 times a day. I usually cook a steak or some kind of meat. I made a bratwurst type thing. I don't eat too many boxed foods. I have for years, but I cut that out here a while back. You have to get to the point where eating is not so much about having a good time or enjoying it or whatever, but just to build your body to maintain. I don't eat fast food. Once in a great while, there's nothing wrong with fast food, but here's a part of a problem with that. You got people lining up for McDonald's, Burger King, and all these places, and then they want to be afraid about getting this current health, I don't want to say the word because I don't want anybody to get banned. They're afraid of getting this current sickness that's going around. I think you all know what I'm talking about. Well, let me tell you, if you would eat good every day, take care of your body, exercise, and take care of the inside, your spiritual being or whatever you want to call it, that entity that makes your heart beat, you wouldn't have to worry near as much about this thing going around, okay? Because you have an immune system that is very powerful, all right? The people who are afraid, now I'm not saying I have no fear. I would be lying. Every day I get up, I have fear about something. You have to face and confront these fears. But what I am saying is your body is a miraculous, marvelous machine, if you want to put it that way. And if you take care of it, it can, okay, why is it some people can be around sickness a lot? Doctors never get sick, okay? Because First off, their beliefs. And they take care of themselves. They have an immune system which fights off these germs, okay? So that's something else. Take care of yourself. Then you don't have to worry about these things. And if something happens to you, like I broke my shoulder about 3 years ago or four, you know, I healed up. I'm okay now. And what did people say? You're not as young as you used to be. I was riding my son's scooter. If I want to ride my son's scooter or climb a tree, I do it. Don't care what other people say. They'll have you on the couch, watching TV, drinking a beer, getting fat. Okay, I could go on and on forever about things like this, but it's very important for you to take care of every aspect of yourself. And then you can live a magnificent life. You can be in shape when you're 60, 70. You can do things. I can climb trees. I can do whatever the hell I want to. I'm in as good a shape as I was in my 20s. I'm in better shape than probably 97% of the people in the U.S. in their 20s now. I can do anything I could do then. I'm in better shape than I was in my teens because I partied and did a lot of drugs. All right? I don't drink alcohol. I don't do drugs. Have nothing against it, but it doesn't work for me. Okay? I drank for many years, partied pretty hard, and it got to where it wasn't any fun anymore, so I stopped. Okay, that's it. This is pretty long. I hope this has helped you. I appreciate Drew asking me to share with you because anything I share with you just reinforces that within myself and helps me probably more than it helps you. Have a great day.
Lego. Damn, it is shit. Scratch game. Face shots to the face. Don't strip on your legs. Mafia. Ready to get it started. Bitch, I got loose.